So now we have human traffic. It's so tight and crazy. No justice, you fall in love. And then we can see the castles, Hong Kong, Hong Kong. One that's hurting, cause they've got the gun. There seems no justice, you fall in love. This is the castle. Like the wrong place for the castle to be. You can park in here. But I will come back, baby, stronger than before. Take my hands, leave me in pain. I will forget you one of these days. Stop me from feeling this way. Look at all these people. Heaven sent, you're directing me insane. Damn, oh boy, why did I call Marilyn? I shouldn't have listened. Oh. I don't want to go to Manhattan. You stay here. Jimmy, stay here. Let me take a picture. You get. You know what time we come back, it will be dark.
Containers were being placed at the various corners for them to eat themselves. But they were not coming from Ghana alone, but faces jury. That is why you cannot underestimate the stench and the heat over here. And as a result, most of them died. And when they died, they were not buried. They were removed and thrown into the ocean for the fish to feed them. They were being given something small to eat just to keep them alive. Some ate Some refuse to eat, they prefer to die. And they never had a time to clean their teeth, nor bath. And all these opinions you see today before had doors on them. So the only source of ventilation came from that hole. And this same hole is connected to another room called the magazine, where they kept their ammunition. So when there's a leakage, the chemicals came straight to this room and worsened a really bad situation. If they were actually in for profit, why let them die? To me, it doesn't make sense, and they will give you two answers. They said, one, Africans were very strong people. Giving them the normal conditions here would make them fight back. And those who could survive through these brutalities were the strong Africans who were wet and died to the people. So in a way, they were trying to eliminate the weaker ones from the stronger ones. But if we all could be sincere for an answer, in the olden days, it was very cheap to come by them. It was very, very expensive to get one person into the dungeon. Then they will make sure that the fellow lives in the normal condition, get a profit, the actual investment, but they never care. That is why, to me, the intention of their coming wasn't to trade, but to loot or steal, not peace, but war, not partnership, but enslavement. A reservoir. Is it what I'm saying is on the scissor, I get a copy.
Okay.
A reservoir built by the Portuguese. They had pipes connected to the roof. There was a pipe over there and not the other one. You're welcome. My name is Philip. I'm saying that this is a reservoir built by the Portuguese. They had pipes connected to the roof. Though the pies over there are not the original. So when it rains, it gets in there. And when it's full, it contains 20,000 gallons of water for cooking, washing, and drinking. But in 1637, when the city up on the balcony there, he stood, our deck and the doors were opened for the 400 women to assemble. He looked through and made his choice. Chosen one might have been the dungeon for 1 to 2 months without cleaning her teeth in the bath. Driving menstruating, yet the governor had paid. So it became the responsibilities of the soldiers to fetch water for her to bath. Now for the bathing, she was given something small to eat, and she was dressed and sent to the
ronda della torre antica, una rondine amica, allo sbocciare del mandorlo è tornata. Ritorna tutti gli anni, sempre alla stessa data, Ponti e Mari e Samarca, per tornare. Oh. penombra dolce della sera.